Skyline Update on BCTV is supported by the Pagoda Skyline Incorporated.
Greetings and welcome to Skyline Update, what's up on the mountain. Join us for the next half hour. We'll give you some updates on things that are happening involving the mountain and the pagoda, and especially the tower, our beloved landmarks. My name is Mike Reinert, and I welcome you. I serve as president of Pagoda Skyline Incorporated. That's a nonprofit organization of volunteers dedicated to the restoration and preservation of the mountain and its landmarks. Particularly right now, we're working a lot on the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower. So we appreciate your interest. I also appreciate my co-host on the program, Corrie Crupi Zana, who's the chair emeritus of Pagoda Skyline Incorporated. That means you can never let her go. You just can't retire from the group. And Corrie, it's always good to have you here too.
Thank you, Mike.
You know, we think of what is up on the mountain. I was just up on the mountain this afternoon before this program, and it is an amazing, inspirational view to be up there at the tower and at the pagoda, to look out over Redding to the west and all the mountains to the east and all the features north and south. It's just a beautiful view. I know some of the trees have gotten pretty tall around some of the lookouts. I know they're working on that, but it's a very special place, and it means a lot to a lot of people. Now, you know, the pagoda and the tower are owned by the city of Redding. So really, they belong to all of us. We're just a nonprofit group of volunteers. We do our part to raise awareness about the mountain and its landmarks, and particularly to help out with the tower right now. And Corrie, I know you've been a volunteer for a long time, and we have a lot of fun.
It's funny that you said that, Mike, because I was just thinking, next year, it'll be 30 years I'm with the group.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
That's fast.
That's a long time. It did go fast. And yes, you're right. I have truly had a lot of fun, and I love being up there on the mountain. And just recently, there was a video that went around on Facebook about my little tour I did at the tower with Tillman Sims and TCL4. It's a group of children that Tillman teaches them how to golf, the ethics and the etiquette of golf. And then during certain months, he takes them to historical sites. But I think Tillman really nailed me to the core. He said, all my passion and my inspiration really comes from my soul. And that hit me because that is true. That is true.
He captured it. Sure, we do what we do. We don't get paid for this. We want to. We enjoy the mountain.
Right.
We enjoy the landmarks. And we do what we can. And especially, I know you, Corrie, you've been very enthusiastic about being a volunteer over the years. And not to play one-upsmanship on you, but just to show how some of us have been involved for so long. I first joined Pagoda Skyline Incorporated in 1976.
Jeez.
I was a student at Burke's campus of Penn State.
Yes.
A lady named Grace Austin was worked at the bookstore, and we started talking about the pagoda. She says, Mike, you got to join our group.
Aww.
It had just formed a few years before that. That's too many years even to count.
Yeah.
But we have some very dedicated volunteers. Mm-hmm. A few good volunteers can really get a lot accomplished.
Exactly.
When we 100%.
Work together. 100%.
Yes. Indeed. And, you know, part of the beauty of the skyline isn't just, you know, being up there, but looking at the views. And I wanted to share a couple of photos I was able to take. You know, it's really amazing to see the sunset at the pagoda. This I just got the other day. And the pagoda has to remain closed for a while yet. It needs some TLC. It needs some plumbing and electrical work and some work under the foundation. The city of Redding is working on that, and another nonprofit called the Foundation for the Redding Pagoda is working on that, and we applaud their efforts and support them also. But standing outside, you can get an amazing view of looking to the west. The sunset at the pagoda. It was a beautiful evening. It was mild, a little breeze going, and always nice to see. Just an amazing place. I also had a chance to take a look at the view from the city looking at the mountain during a recent storm. And here we're looking from the West Reading Wyomissing area, looking eastward over Reading. And there you can see the tower on the left-hand side of the screen. You see a little nub sticking up. That's the tower. And on the right-hand side, you can see where the pagoda is. And there was just a big squall coming across the city. Stormy skyline. So it's not just the view from skyline, but the views you get of skyline from different areas. Wherever I'm at, I like to take a look around and see if I can see the pagoda from there. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a joke in our family. Say, can Dad see the pagoda from here? Yeah, there it is.
a lot of people tell me that when they see the pagoda, they know their home.
Indeed.
Yeah.
I remember George Mizer saying that in an interview on TV one time.
Oh.
So whenever you travel anywhere, whenever you see the pagoda, you know your home in Reading.
Right.
So thank you for letting me share that picture. I have another one, too. I took of the tower at dusk. Our organization has been meeting at the fire tower, and we had a meeting, and it was just starting to get dark as we were wrapping up. Not that we were talking a lot extra, but we didn't go real long. It just happened to be the time of year. It gets dark around 7:30. We meet from 6 o'clock to 7:30, usually on the second Wednesday of the month. And it got this picture of the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower. The lights had just come on, and you can see the deep blue color of the sky at dusk. And the tower is really something we want to talk a little bit about. It's an important part of our community, too. The pagoda and the tower are like old friends on the mountain. We wouldn't want to lose either of them. And the tower itself has an important function, fire observation. It was built in 1939 as a WPA project for fire observation, and it's still used by DCNR, the Department of it was a conservation of natural resources. And some of the firefighters, especially when there's a red flag warning, if it's very dry, the dew point's low, and it's windy, and it's a hot day, there can be forest fires. And the fire observers will go up to the top. I know, Corrie, you've done that too. And if you see some smoke coming, you can see better where it's coming from when you're on top looking down on it, and they can more efficiently dispatch the crews.
Mm-hmm.
I know you've done that recently.
I have. We also man the fire tower when the city of Reading holds fireworks on New Year's Eve. So we do a fire watch, and like you said, we can see the lights of the emergency vehicles going through the mountain. And because we're up top, we can pinpoint for them and lead them in that direction to the center of the fire. So it is a useful tool to have for firefighting.
Indeed. You may not realize that when you're at the tower, how high above sea level you are. The fire tower itself, the piece of ground that it's on, is the crest of Mount Penn. And that is the fifth highest point in Berks County. When you're standing there in front of the tower at the base, it's 1,120 feet above sea level, 1,120 feet above sea level. And when you go through the tower itself, which is 120 feet tall, when you're on top of the tower, you're 1,240 feet above sea level. So you're really way up there. And it's amazing the view you can get. Mm-hmm. You can even see in the Philly someday.
You
right?
can. You can see the glitter of the sun sparkling off the roofs of the buildings in Philadelphia. Is and it? I've seen it.
Liberty One, right?
Yeah.
And of course, you can see the Limerick nuclear plant from there.
The
too.
Limerick, so yes, you can. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they say it's a 60-mile view all around. And our fire tower sits in the middle of a triangle. It was Port Clinton to the north, Lancaster and Hopewell, and we are right in the middle of that. And back in the day when DCNR, the Bureau of Forestry, was manning the fire tower, they would all communicate with each other. And we actually have at the top of the tower an original, it's called an alidade, which is, it's a very cool round map. And you use some type of a, I don't know what it would be called, and you get the longitude, latitude, the actual area where you see smoke, and that is how they would dispatch. And we have that original alidade on top of the tower, so we're happy.
That's great. That's where you can see, I remember that song from the 70s, you can see the smoke from a distant fire.
Oh.
Remember that song?
Yes, Sanford I do.
Sanford Townsend in 1977. It was playing when I did my first newscast on WRAW.
Oh.
But that's another topic for another show. But you're right, that alidade is very helpful, and that's something that's up at the top of the tower. Mm-hmm. By the way, while we're talking about the tower, let's have a TQ quiz, shall we? Because we like to learn things, right? You're supposed to learn something new every day. And we like to present the TQ question, the tower quiz, and see if you know which of these statements is true about the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower. Is it A, the tower has a clock on top? Is it B, the tower has a gift shop? Is it C, the tower has a balcony at the top? Or is it D, the tower has a glass elevator? Which is true about the tower? Now I'm going to start by saying D, that was just my wishful thinking.
That would be nice.
That would be nice.
I keep asking people, please apply for a grant. Let's get an elevator, okay?
That's right. So that's just wishful thinking. It's not D. You still have to walk up the 168 steps to get to the top. How about A, does a tower have a clock on top? Now, I was just having a little fun with that. Reading Hospital has a tower with a clock on top.
Oh.
And that's how the name Tower Health came from, the clock tower. Feature right there at 6th and Penn Avenue. That's not A. And B, does the tower have a gift shop? I don't know where we'd put it if we did.
No,
it's a little tight.
Doesn't have a gift shop.
The Pagoda had at one time.
Yeah, it did.
And we had to disband that as the Pagoda was closed during the pandemic. So the answer is C, if you guessed correctly. The answer is C. The tower has a balcony on the top. Or as you called it today, Corrie,
a parapet. I called it. Yeah.
And you can go out and walk around the top of the tower. And you have an incredible view up there. Matter of fact, it's about the only place I know of where you can stand and look down on the pagoda, which is actually lower.
Yes, you're right.
So that's a little bit of extra trivia about the tower. And maybe someday we will have that glass elevator. Some of the things that we like to talk about are the history of the mountain. And it's not just the pagoda and the tower, and of course, Duryea Drive and Skyline Drive, but the mountain itself has a lot of history. And Corrie, you wanted to talk about an unusual hermit who had a winery called Keuchler's Roost.
Right.
What's up with that?
And Keuchler's Roost, my favorite subject, my favorite stop along the gravity rail. I wanted to let you all know, on October 8th, mark your calendars, October 8th, from 12 noon till about 3, I'm going to be leading a hike to Keuchler's Roost. It's sponsored by the Berks History Center. I will be accompanied by Rick Politica. I want you to know you do need to call the Berks History Center to make a reservation. There is a $5 charge for members and an $8 charge for non-members. But I can tell you that that small fee is well worth it. I'm going to give you the number to the Berks History Center. That is 610-375-4375. Give them a call if you'd like to get yourself scheduled to go on the hike October 8th, 12 noon to 3 to Keuchler's Roost. And we meet at the fire tower at 12 o'clock that day.
So Corrie just told us to take a hike.
Take a hike.
Thanks, Corrie.
Yes,
that you're
sounds
welcome. Like a fun day.
It's going to be a fun hike. Okay, so we did bring along some pictures of Keuchler's Roost. And as we put the pictures up, I'd like to talk a little bit about Jacob Lewis Keuchler, or Herr Keuchler, as a lot of people would call him. He originally started out operating a saloon at 534 Penn Street. There he is. What a cool guy. Very known for his black velvet beret, his white beard, and his long stem pipe. He was a very intelligent man and really well-liked. From his days of running the saloon, he made a lot of friends. He made a lot of devoted friends. And in 1882, when Keuchler headed to the hills to get away from society and run away from the world, he purchased 9 acres along Spur Road, or List Road, as you call it today. He built this little stube, which was his home. Once the gravity railroad began in 1888, his place became really popular, and it was the most popular stop on the gravity rail. It was stop number 9 on the ticket. People would get off and walk downward towards Keuchler's Roost, where you could enjoy a nice pig roast, some Hasenpfeffer, Hasenpfeffer lunches, which is rabbit stew, wine, beer, soda. The gravity really brought a lot of people to the tower. This particular piece is a hand-carved table and chair set that was saved from the Roost. This was actually in the second Roost. And I wanted to tell you about Keuchler. January 2nd, 1904, that was the first time Mr. Keuchler had been off that mountain in a long time. January 2nd, 1904, they had to call the ambulance and take him down from the mountain. Herr Keuchler passed away January 2nd, 1904, at the age of 74, and he is buried in the Charles Evans Cemetery. His daughter, Anna, owned a business, a tannery business, with her husband, Ferdinand Goetz. They had an employee, Carl August Schaik, who in 1907 made them an offer to purchase the building. Schaik purchased the building and restored it as a beautiful Swiss chalet. This particular piece, the table and chair, they can be seen at the Berks History Center. They are on display over there.
Is that the Stammtisch? Right?
That's the Stammtisch. And if you kind of look, you can see a little bell in the center of the table. Rick Politica actually one day found that bell in the basement of the Berks History Center and returned it to the center of the Stammtisch. So every time I go over there, I just have to go up. I say hello to Jacob's huge poster they have over there, and I have to touch the table and chairs. But I want to tell you that the second Roost by Carl Schaik was still called Keuchler's Roost, and that entertained many, many, many people also, especially people that were brought up on the gravity or people walk the trails. If you look in the bottom right-hand corner, that is where that table and chair sat. This is the back of the Roost, and you can't see it, but off to the right, there was a matching observation platform where you could climb to the top and you could look down over the valley of Lower Alsace. Then on the bottom half of that pavilion, there was a bowling alley. So it was really a cool place to go where you could just sit all day and eat, have a lunch, have a pig roast, or enjoy some of the handmade soda. They made ginger, like a ginger ale soda, and they made a sarsaparilla up there also, besides their homemade wine and beer.
Sounds like an interesting place up there on the back of Mount Penn.
It was.
And now there's a little piece of this left, isn't there? The wine cellar is back behind Rotary Park off of List Road.
The wine cellar and a small set of stairs I discovered are still up there. But if you would like to read more, look at this. This is a picture nobody has seen. I believe I got it from George Meiser. This is on the back, it said Keuchler's Roost. So this is some type of little hut, possibly a little hunting cabin or something like that, that was on the property. So that is a very rare photograph. And there's no way of telling what it is. Oh, look at this. This is the gravity platform. So you can see some of the open gravity cars, how people would, there were two coupled together that were pulled up by a steam engine and then descended upon the mountain past Keuchler's by gravity, and people would pack those cars. This is actually in Pandora Park. That's where the terminus was.
Yeah, so that would probably be somewhere in the very early 1900s.
Probably. And this is the Swiss Chalet. This is Carl Schaik's Keuchler's Roost. It's a shame, but this property burnt to the ground in 1919 by a stray firecracker. And we are so lucky that they did save the table and chair from Keuchler's, and we are lucky enough to have that on display at the Berks History Center.
And that feature on the left, that is the door to the wine cellar,
isn't it?
That is. And that is still there. Mm-hmm,
that's correct.
That is still there today, if you know, want to take a little hike back through Rotary Park.
Right, October 8th, we're going. So if you wanted to read more about the gravity, or read more about any of the stops, or the Pagoda, or the Tower, or Skyline Drive, you could pick up a copy of my book. We do have it at the Berks History Center, or probably something you could get a hold of me, Mike, any one of the members of Pagoda Skyline, and we can get a book for you if you so like.
Thank you for sharing that, Corrie. There's a lot of interesting history on the mountain.
There is.
A lot of good stories that the mountain has to tell us.
That's right.
And
that
we try to preserve those also. If you'd like to know more about our group, Pagoda Skyline Incorporated, you can log on to pagodaskyline.org. We also have webcams. We have one on top of the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower and one in the pagoda that's just been repaired. And they are, I believe it's a fresh view every 5 minutes. So you can take a look and take a look out over the area and see what we're doing.
I believe if you go to our website, which is pagodaskyline.org, go on the very, very bottom, I believe in blue, you can hit on either the pagoda or the tower cam.
All right. Mm-hmm. And really, we're blessed to have great support within our community, and we appreciate it, the community support for our group, for all of our mountain partners, too. Again, we said there's the foundation for the Reading Pagoda that's working on the pagoda. Our group, Pagoda Skyline Incorporated, we have the agreement with the city to help with the fire tower. And there's the Blue Mountain Region Sports Car Club of America that puts on the hill climb, the Duryea and Pagoda Hill Climbs. They do a lot of cleanups and some improvements also for Skyline Drive and Duryea Drive. Nice group to work with. There's the Mount Penn Preserve, the Council of Governments, the partnerships that's working to promote the entire mountain as a destination in mapping out some of the trails. There's the BAMBA, the Berks Area Mountain Biking Association, and some other groups. And each of us has a focus area working together for the good of the community to preserve that that beautiful mountain. And, one of the things that the fire tower needs a little bit of TLC, too. I guess we're going to be working on identifying some mortar repair on the inside. It's a stone tower. That means it's porous. It gets moisture in there, and sometimes pieces of mortar flake off. So we're going to be working on doing some of that as well.
Mm-hmm. And another thing I want to mention, since you're talking about the fire tower, April 22nd is going to be our next chicken barbecue.
That's a cleanup.
That's a cleanup.
April
22nd is the Duryea Hill Climb cleanup. So we will be all over Skyline, all over Duryea, in partnership with the city and the Blue Mountain Regional Sports Car Club. So come on up and join us. It's somewhere around Earth Day. It is Earth Day, April 22nd.
Mm-hmm.
Come on up on Skyline. And then the 29th of April, the last Saturday in April, will be our chicken barbecue at the fire tower.
You're really working ahead.
I am. Right. I want everybody to come up because we're going to have it this year. We got tamped down during COVID, but now we're back up and running and everything will be clean, sanitized, and safe.
That's right. So a lot of good things to look forward to. And, of course, also at the tower, the annual Easter Dawn service on Easter, which will be April 9th of 2023, the 110th Easter Dawn service. A lot of good things going on up in
there. April.
The thing about April, but we have to have Christmas first, which is a little over 3 months away now.
Okay.
It's coming.
anyway. I'm thinking about Halloween next, and then Thanksgiving, and then Christmas.
it all comes in order, all the seasons. But we're here, and we appreciate your interest in this program and on what Pagoda Skyline Incorporated is doing to keep things preserved on the mountain. We have to thank all of our donors. We want to thank all of our members. We want to thank all of our volunteers who do a wonderful job for our preservation efforts. And also here at BCTV, for these folks here, that give us a forum so we can tell you what is up on the mountain. I want to thank Corrie Crupi Zana, who's the Chair Emeritus of Pagoda Skyline Incorporated, telling us a little more about Keuchler's Roost, an interesting place on the mountain. And I want to thank you for your interest. On behalf of everyone at Pagoda Skyline Incorporated, my name is Mike Reinert. I say thank you for watching, and God bless you all, and we'll see you next time.
Skyline Update on BCTV is supported by the Pagoda Skyline Incorporated.